Basically, Some sort of mask requirement.
How about you, Jack? Leave me.
California bartender Rebecca Fernandez found herself on the receiving end of a customer's racist tirade. Fernandez says he refused to wear a mask. More than 20 major retail chains, including Advance, Best Buy, and Dollar Tree, wrote on CNN.com that states must pass laws require a mask. Dr. Anthony Fauci is also putting the onus on state and local leaders.
Be as forceful as possible in getting your citizenry to wear masks.
A message that Lily Dantel hopes comes through loud and clear for her sake and all those facing fights over face coverings.
I'm not going to give up. I'm still going to ask you to wear a mask if you come to my store. If you want a mask, I'm still going to ask you to wear a mask. I'm not backing down.
State leaders aren't backing down here in Virginia. The governor is sending in inspectors to places like bars and restaurants and hotspots like Hampton Roads looking for masks. Enforcement's also being stepped up in places like Miami. The mask order in Arkansas goes into effect today.
John Finch, with their own pain, overwhelmingly supports mask wearing here. So what you're seeing is you're seeing small pockets, I think, which can skew the perception you might think about other things. Some teachers say they would rather take fully retired than risk getting coronavirus in the classroom. We'll speak more than next.
Hi, your name is Darren. Like you, I'm at home staying too. I don't want you to get this special job. To make these uncertain times, if you're here and stable while at home, Medicare Advantage plans have added new benefits, including telephone appointments with your doctors, in-home aid, home-delivered meals, all-delivered prescriptions, and so much more. But you won't get all the benefits automatically. You need to enroll. The easiest way to enroll is to call the Medicare Coverage Helpline. It's now more important than ever to make sure your Medicare coverage is up to date. We all have a few minutes to make a phone call to focus on our health. Get what you're entitled to. Call now. It's free.
Call 1-800-516-0600. That's 1-800-516-0600 now.
Attention Medicare recipients. The Antigen 1 portable oxygen concentrator may now be available at little or no cost to you. Call 800-516-0600. To order yours today, Antigen oxygen concentrators are portable and make oxygen from the air around you. They're light, quiet, and battery operated to go everywhere you go. And we have a full line of portable oxygen units to fit a wide range of budgets. If you want Medicare, you may be qualified to get an Antigen unit at little or no cost to you. Go back to joining friends for the breakfast special. Expedite. Time with the grandkids easier. Or start attending your religious services again. Call Antigen now for a free information kit and a free elongation consultation on our complete line of affordable portable oxygen products. And any order on Medicare. Call 800-550-8759. That's 800-550-8759.
Just hold in your hand, put it back, cause you can, wrist and arm pain instead. Just watching your device on the couch, make your head say, ouch, when you need to get comfortable. You need pillow pads. The Moody Angle Pillow Stand makes even a device comfortable and hands-free, wherever you happen to be. The secret is in pillow pads, toilet design, that gives you three different view angles with a perfect view every time. All you do is work this to find the view that works best for you. And here's the best part, with three perfect view angles, you can comfortably view your device sitting while you even lie down. Pillow pads made from a breakthrough cushion foam that's ultra lightweight and super soft to gently rest in your lap. Plus, it's permanent, so you can swipe right or tight with precision and speed. No more struggling to hold your tablet. Now with pillow pads, you can view hands-free, pain-free, and comfortably. And because of pillow pads' non-slip fabric and innovative wedge design, it securely holds all your devices, large or small. You fit them all. It's the most comfortable way to fit one. Stay connected on social media, video chat with friends or family. It's great for keeping the kids happy in the car or to mold kids. It works out the pain, and it's not just for devices. Use pillow pads to display recipes, and there's no better way to read your favorite book than with them. Everyone loves pillow pad because it provides arms, wrist, and joint comfort. Plus, the cover is removable and 100% machine washable. Cover no online dialing for pillow pad. Pick your choice of gray, blue, or green. Pick for the special PD discount price of just $19.99. But wait, order right now. We'll upgrade you to the deluxe pillow pad with a built-in mind, disorder glasses, earphones, and more. Absolutely free. Plus,
viewer call Melina. 3-4-4-6-1-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-2-4-9-
of the pandemic and tightening its public health restrictions. CNN has reported all around the world for you for this film. I'm in Ripley and Central Hong Kong, where people are out on the streets, but almost everybody wearing a mask. The city is expanding its requirements for people to wear masks. One of the social distancing measures are being heightened as it grapples with a third wave of COVID-19. City leaders say it's not even close to being under control. The number of cases every day has now topped the 100 mark after the first visit of the pandemic, and non-essential city workers are being told to stay home this week. A lot of businesses are closed, and those that do remain open have to conduct temperature screening at the door to try to make sure the customers are safe and try to keep the virus from spreading even more here.
Employees back to work, and the country's chief scientific advisor says there's no need to change the current work-from-home policy. The Prime Minister has given greater powers to local councils across the country to have local lockdowns if there are local outbreaks. That's the key to the one. Not as he says, in the British Herald.
I'm Shasta Darlington in Sao Paulo. The total number of COVID-19 cases on Sunday, based on data from Johns Hopkins University, more than 161,000 people in the region have died from the coronavirus. Brazil, the hardest hit country, with nearly 2.1 million infections. Over the weekend, Brazilian President Jair Bolsonaro greeted supporters earlier this month. Our thanks to all of our correspondents there. So, for this morning, school teachers around the country are wrestling with a very tough choice. Should they return to their jobs and risk their health? Sure, Booker T. Kennedy Washington High School in Miami. Thank you so much for being here. So I know that not only are you in school, teacher, as you have been for 16 years, but your wife is a nurse at the Jackson Health System. We interview doctors from there all the time. We know the crisis that's going on in those hospitals. So what are your conversations like?
Well, we're very much concerned because, as you know, Jackson has a very high rate of COVID patients. Social distancing, wearing masks, things of that nature. And so that's what the governor of Miami Dade comes home every day, not knowing, you know, what the situation is.
I believe it's in Florida. Schools are canceled, so what have you decided to do?
It's something that I don't really look forward to because, you know, teaching has been a passion of mine, as you said, for 16 years. And, you know, I don't look forward to leaving, but I think I have to at this point.
I'm sorry to hear that. And I read that you loved your job and that you would take in to continue doing your job.
That's correct. I mean, it's been a real passion. I've had many success as many students to go on and earn their PhD, their law degree, and coming from the type of community that Booker T is located in, you know, that's astounding to have those students overcome the hurdles and obstacles in their way and become, you know, rightfully in their own space. You know, and, well, a lot of things came into play, as you mentioned. The wife, she's a nurse, staying, going to the hospital every day, coming home, that played into my decision, but also my age. You know, age where I would be eligible to retire. So I said this might be the right time because I do want to enjoy, you know, some of the hard work that I put in over the years. But if I contract COVID-19, then, you know, that could be in jeopardy.
That makes perfect sense. And what about your friends and colleagues from the school? I know you've had conversations with them too, even some of the younger folks. What are they telling you?
Well, so, you know, and, you know, Helen, here's what I have something to fall back on. But I know many of the older teachers that I talk with, they are very much interested in retiring. Now, as you know, when you retire, you're looking at living for a fixed income and finances become important. And so that's the prime consideration.
It's a hardship. But it's believing that you need love and you have that purpose that you've had for so long. And so, Mr. Jennings, we really appreciate you sharing your personal thought process with us. And we wish you the best of luck going forward. And, you know, stay healthy and we wish the same for your wife.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for being on. Yes, I know two people are alike. You customize your car insurance, you only pay for what you need.
Good morning, everyone. You had a nice
this weekend. I'm talking Arlo Dimchino had the day off and just, again, state shattering records for new cases of coronavirus and the leaders of some of the hardest hit cities this morning mulling another stay-at-home order. 31 states seeing cases on the rise. You see it in the map there. In Florida, dozens of hospitals are now out of ICU beds. In Arizona, 87 doctors are pleading with the governor to push back reopening schools until at least October. And a growing number of major retailers mandating customers wear masks in their stores nationwide. Walmart really leading the way in enforcing the policy starting today. Also, Delta Airlines is starting another screening process for passengers who cannot wear a mask on board for health reasons. They're even asking those passengers to consider not traveling at all. As for the president, he is not just standing by his response to more than 140,000 Americans have died from COVID-19. He is once again in an interview downplaying the severity of the pandemic. We'll get to that moment. Let's begin with the state of Georgia, which saw a weekend of record cases. I doubt there's from land. Good morning, Diane. Good morning, Poppy. Look, things are going in the wrong direction all across the country right now. 31 states are seeing an increase in their new cases of COVID-19. And the U.S. passed over 140,000 mark when it comes to deaths since the start of this pandemic. Now, Vice President Mike Pence is holding a close call with U.S. governors to talk about COVID-19 this afternoon. We're seeing cases in states just like Georgia that are hitting record numbers of new cases in some of these states from just this weekend, Poppy. The governor, Brian Kemp there, is seeking a restraining order. So not only is Michael Bloomberg, he sued Atlanta's mayor last week for mandating masks in Atlanta, although he hasn't sued other mayors of other cities in Georgia, like Athens, we'll have later on in the program, for doing the same. But now he's trying to essentially muzzle her, right? Get injunctions from the court so that she can't speak about it, speak freely to the press, is that right?
Yes, no mask mandates, but definitely an injunction to muzzle the mayor, it looks like. The governor's office says that this is essentially because they view her comments and her comments to the press and press releases as confusing for business owners. Essentially, this emergency injunction requests that they prevent the mayor of Atlanta from speaking to the press or issuing any press releases about her COVID-19 restrictions because they go above what the governor has put out with his public health emergency executive order. That's essentially the root of that lawsuit that's filed against her as well. But of course, this takes it a step further, essentially saying that they want to make it to where she can't speak about it at all. Now, the mayor has said that's not going to happen. She's going to continue talking about it, continue telling people to listen to the science so they can stay safe. There haven't been a court date yet set in this lawsuit.
Okay, Diane, wow, that is a best one. Thank you very much. Let's go to Miguel Marquez, my colleague. He's in Arizona for us this morning. Good morning, Miguel. That is a state that I think it's a mix of some positive news and a lot of bad news. What is the state of Arizona experiencing right now?
Yeah, the state is at a real crossroads. The case numbers here, that rate of positivity is through the roof. It leads the nation about 24%, 3.5% of all people tested here when an emergency test site has been popped up in the next 12 days or so. About a quarter of people being tested here are positive. Over the weekend, they shattered the number of deaths reported in a single day, 147 deaths on Saturday. But the rate of transmission is down slightly, so I have it. The rate of which I spread it to others is back down slightly. The rate of hospitalization, those are the hospital beds across the entire state, that is down slightly. But we've seen to healthcare professional after healthcare professional, we go to one doctor, who says they are overwhelming, they're going at it for nonstop. And right now, some healthcare professionals are trying to get sick. So people are sick. The rest of us are sick. This started. I'm a researcher. I wanted to save the world. I only had this problem. I'm calling y'all, but it's funny. I just want to get out of line. You know, that's my goal. I'm going to get AIDS, I can die, and I don't like that. So I'm worried nothing better. I'm worried that a lot of people being naive about this.
Now, Arizona is looking at the fall, which will bring people back to this part of the country, and that may hurt even more virus spread. They have so much virus out there right now that it would be very difficult to pull it all back in. Remember, in mid-May, Arizona opened up the state very aggressively. They went from 0 to 100, basically. They didn't have sort of the stages and steps like you had in New York and other places, and it shows. You watch the numbers just flying exponentially. Now they have just tons of virus out there in the community. The big question now facing the governor and the state is how do they stick to the plan to open schools in August? They're supposed to open August 1st. The governor's pushed that back to a hopeful date of August 17th.
And 87 doctors are like meeting with anecdotally from parents and both of because you got hear that doctor say, I just want to get out of this alive. It says so much.
Yeah, so the governor has said this week actually they're going to make that decision on when schools will reopen. He has basically hinted at that this 17th is an aspirational date. We'll see. This group of doctors now want to push that to at least October, if not farther. The issue is, can kids spread it? And if they can, is it going to stick in the children? If they can spread it around the older the child, the more possibly up to 200 adults. Does it make kids as sick? Not necessarily, but there are some diseases, even as we see in the findings, that can completely devastate children. So it's a very, very tough question. And how you get back to normal now with all this virus out there? You know, look, you get this thing from work, from people very, sometimes.
And no mask mandate across the state, right? I know cities can decide, but no.
No mask mandate across the state. No mask mandate across the state. The governor won't do it. Most big cities, most counties have put money into effect. So effectively, much of the state is, but the governor has not mandated the mask. He wears one public, not anti-mask. But there was a period where he didn't engage fully in that. He opened up the state very quickly, completely aggressively, and now there's one of the things.
Miguel, thank you for that reporting on the ground. We appreciate it very, very much. There are no more warnings for not wearing a mask in Miami. Starting today, people call about being spring will start
the outline for you guys. So far, more than 350,000 people have tested positive for COVID-19 in Florida. It's the state or its own country. It would have the seventh most cases in the world. I'm joined now by Carlos Rico, who is president and CEO of Jackson Health, Miami-Dade County Public Hospital System. It's very good to have you. Thank you for being here. And not only how many people you're treating, but you have 13,000 employees that work across your healthcare system. The increase in COVID-19 patients, Carlos, in the last month, 226%. You said a few days ago we have plans B, C, and D as to how we convert our recovery beds and how we convert other things to ICU beds. We're not at that point at this time. How close are you?
So we continue to hear. Good morning, Bobby. Thank you very much. The Jackson Memorial, our main hospital, is used to that because we have a lot of complex surgeries, including transplant, nerve surgery, open heart, and we need a lot of the ICU beds. We're building 100 new ICU beds, but unfortunately, they're not going to be around until the end of the year. So really, every day, we're going to have a challenge of how we make sure we do that. And that's with the current ICU beds. We do have, as you said, my BNC, on how to have additional beds. And even though we've seen a little bit of a blending out, we've only seen a growth of 60% in the last 14 days, in the Pacific ICU, only 18%, we expect those numbers to grow a little higher, and for that reason, we may be going to plant BNC in place.
You know, we talk so much about available ICU beds or ICU beds not being available. I think it's important to also focus on, I mean, the staff. You have so many, you have 13,000, and how exhausted they're getting, and how sick some are getting. More. Last week, when 150 of your staff were out with COVID, I wonder what that number is now, and also your response to some of the doctors. Dr. Martin said it's not just about having available beds for the patients. We need the support staff, the nurses, the techs to take care of them, and they've been hiring many more nurses, he said, to help out. What is the strain like on your team right now?
Well, we are in the fifth month already of this infection here in South Florida. Well, obviously, that's a challenge in the anxiety, the kind of work that these people are doing, and the fear of those women is really amazing. And frankly, when you look at the healthcare workers, it's extremely important, the kind of work they're doing, and the challenge that they're under is extremely difficult. But I will say this, today we have right at 200 employees that are out with positive COVID. For those, only 37 are nurses. We have 4,000 nurses. From a percentage standpoint, not a big number. I will say that the state, the government, the Senate, is not going to be by providing extra 200 nurses to us at this point in time. And that actually has been extremely important for us. We won't hire another 9,500 nurses, but all of that is less at this point in time. It's a big challenge and a lot of anxiety for everyone.
Speaking about your employees, a union that represents 5,000 of your healthcare workers, they are asking for hazard pay. And they say our workers are being worked past their limits. We lost lives from this pandemic. We face the real risk of losing more before it's over. Are you able to and open to paying them increased wages for being on the front lines? I know you are in quite a financial precarious position yourself in the hospital system right now.
We brought this point up originally ourselves to the unions, and frankly, at this point in time, we've lost in excess of $80 million that we have not been able to catch up with the federal support. But we have not gotten any funding from HHS, but that's been brought to the papers that they've not specifically to St. Peter Hospital and Hospital Hospital, for which we qualified to vote that they did not get anything money on any of those things. But we are financially challenged from that point. And I know at one point when the bill looked at for hazard pay, we would love to be able to do something like that, but financially, we can't do it. And frankly, no other hospital in the country is doing that at this point in time. Not that we're looking at just other hospitals, but financially, we've been doing it.
Okay, thank you, Carlos, very much for your time this morning. Good luck to you guys.
Thank you.
Well, as the cases are going up, the president's poll numbers, especially on handling COVID, are going down. Still, he is standing firm on his strategy or lack of a national plan in the pandemic. The question politically is why. We'll talk about that also. There was another violent night in Portland, Oregon. Federal forces using tear gas to disrupt protesters taking lives there. And a search is on for a gunman reportedly grabbed a FedEx driver who opened fire at the home of a federal judge in New Jersey. The judge's son was killed. Her husband was shot. Just tragedy. We'll have a live report from there as well.
Some cellular plan, I can stay frankly for an hour a day if I want.
Oh, you didn't have
a
couch.
That's all. Stay out. You can't see how much you can save at consumercellular.com.
All right, I guess my first thing is going to tap one very important thing you want to do.
How do you mean?
Well, I think we're talking about this collaborating in ways that we've never done before. In our week, we could restaurant tend to be our part of the project that are show positive results. There's several promising pressing countries. Because science? Nine. Science is how we get back to normal. The shark that optimized